Good morning, everyone. Let's begin our lecture number 4, page 5. And this is lesson number 1, Christopher. This was learning at home. Now, this is answer key. Question number 7. How did Ophero carry the child across the river? And the correct answer is, Ophero put the child on his shoulders and waded through the angry river. So if you remember, the boy was not ready to wait for the night, though it was thundering, lightning, rough atmosphere. So Ophero helped him and took him across the river on his shoulders. How did Ophero come to be known as Christopher? Answer is, when people came to know he carried child Christ on his shoulders, he came to be known as Christopher. So when Ophero helped that little child, took him across the river, and that little child was going away, so Ophero saw light around the boy. Then he realized that is child Christ. And when people came to know this information or thing about Ophero and the child, they gave him Christopher name. And this Christopher is saint name. Now question number 2. Complete each sentence. So this is incomplete sentence. We have to complete it remembering the story. Number 1. Ophero was a noble person because he was kind and helping. He was kind and helping in nature, and he was very good person. Number 2. The old man wanted Ophero's help because he wanted to go other side of the river. Right. And second thing, he didn't know how to swim. Understood, my friends? Now, dear friends, complete his sentence again. This is third question. The old man looked at Ophero with deep gratitude. The old man looked at the Ophero with deep gratitude when he reached other side of the river. The old man looked at Ophero with deep gratitude when he reached other side of the river. Ophero helped him. We remember, right, dear friends? So now next question. Ophero knew that he had carried child Christ across the river when? And when? When he saw light around the child. There was light around the child. Therefore, he came to know that he is child Christ. Now, let's begin our word power. Word power. This is 1. It is a building where Hindus go to worship. And yes, if you remember, you can write down the worship place for Hindus. That is temple. This temple. Now number two. It's a building where Muslims go to worship, and that is mosque. 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 It is a building where Christians go to worship, and everyone knows it is church. CHURCH. So these are the worship place of these Hindus, Muslims, and Christians. So dear friends, this is learning at home. Write the worshipping places of these two categories. Till then, have a nice day. Bye-bye.